been. And again, modesty and perspiration problems are another reason why so many laborers were born. A properly dressed 19th century woman would have had at least 10 items of clothing on. But there is an exception to this rule. This bodice that I have on this dress form has a shoulder sleeve. A lady should never, unless she is working class, her forearms would not show in the daytime. That was considered improper. It was vulgar, and your skin would become brown. Brown skin denoted someone of lower class who didn't have someone working in that vegetable garden for them. So even that, she should have a longer sleeve on. So for this bodice, this item of clothing known as an undersleeve would have gone on. It just comes above the elbow, but it does cover my forearm, so that's not being shown. Also, higher necklines in the daytime to keep the sun off of our skin. If you look at some of the pictures, some of the older pictures in Kentucky, it's really sometimes hard to age our ancestors because they didn't worship the sun and lay out in it like we do. So they didn't have all the skin wrinkles and the sunspots and all of it because they kept their skin covered. So depending on your outer clothing, that could vary, but your underclothing was all the same every day. Every day. Unless you weren't receiving guests, and then you could stay inside the house and just have on a robe or a wrapper, as they call it, but you wouldn't be talking to anybody. First item of clothing, of course, would be boots or shoes. This is sort of a, I couldn't find my original shoes. I tucked them away for safekeeping. But their shoes would either lace or tie up the front or on the side, depending on the popularity of the region where you live, and then cotton stockings were put on. And you can tell mine have been well worn. These came in three colors, black, beige, and white. You had your choice. White was usually saved for special occasions, for dances, for parties, because obviously you could soil them easy, and then that would be another item to have to wash. So black or tan or brown were worn primarily through the daytime to keep showing dirt, keep that to a minimum. After that was gone, you had on you started putting on your undergarments, and these are known as pantalettes. Little boys wore pantaloons. Girls wear pantalettes. And like Miss Scarlett, when she lifted up her skirt and stepped off that stool, Rex said he didn't know a woman in Paris that wore pantalettes. She didn't want him to talk about it, but she knew about it. And when I do my presentations for the school kids, they all just bust up laughing because of the way these are made. And there is a reason for this. And to us adults, it's quite obvious. With the kids, I have to say, oh gosh, I've had six glasses of lemonade, and then they all get it. But anyway, because when the next item of clothing goes on, you will understand why they're made this way. As a reenactor and living in the 21st century, you have to remember when you go to the potty, there's several layers you have to lift up before you sit down. I made that mistake once. The next item of clothing was known as a chemise. This also could double as a gown, and you can see why. Most chemises were cotton. Some ladies were fortunate enough to have a lot of money in their family, and they were made from silk. Silk breathes, so does cotton. And in 90-degree weather, we need all the breather we can get. So a chemise went on next, because the next item of clothing, if you wear it against your bare skin, you're just asking for a disaster. This is known as a corset. I'm laced in a corset, and this is my fancy corset. Corsets were worn by the ancient Egyptians in early times and were passed down and worn for years and years and years until about 1918 when the brassiere was invented, and that replaced this. I forget how many stays this one has in it, but I'm going to pass this now. Of course, it fastens in the front, and it laces up the back. This makes it easy to put on because you can get yourself fastened. around and I'll let you feel of the fabric and the construction. And if you want to come up and pat me down, that's fine too. I laced mine from top to center and bottom to center, sort out the strings, and you can pull one section at a time. Now, if you've got somebody that's close by, they can help get the top and the bottom, the very bottom, tighter where it needs to be. But that corset starts here and it ends here. So now you can see with stainless steel stays in it, you can see now why the undergarments were fashioned as they were. You can't just roll this thing up and sit down. It don't work that way.
Mm-hmm. Would the husband ever help put, you know, tighten that up or anything? Or?
Yes. Constantly.
Yes. And our soldiers are well trained in camp.
Camp life is not all battlefield.
Or like Captain Jack Sparrow on the Pirates of the Caribbean. Listen, there have been times in the summertime when I was just, it feels like there's a gremlin behind me taking those ties and just twisting and pulling because you swell with the heat and humidity in the daytime. And there have been many times when I've come into camp and I thought, man, who's got a pocket knife that could just rip this thing up the back and get me out of it? Now, over top of the corset, because of the metal stays, it was considered improper or poor taste for those stays to show through your outer clothing. So a corset cover was worn over top of that corset. Now this is an original from about 1920, and it's silk. A lot of them were cotton, and in the wintertime you might even have an outing cloth or flannel or a lightweight wool to help keep you warm. But here's you, you get all these clothes on, you're not going to be cold. I don't let the kids handle this, but I will let you adults look at this. It's just, it's a beautiful piece of clothing. Now, we're going to put on this petticoat. This is called a modesty petticoat because when you lift your skirt, ladies, to go up and down the staircase or to get in and out of a carriage or perhaps ride on horseback, it was considered improper for your pantalettes to be seen. That's why you had on a chemise that helped cover that up. But this also helped to disguise the chemise. It's called a modesty petticoat. It's very